Wow. That is good. Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to our church annual picnic, and the kids are all playing. Probably pretty soon they will be coming back here. And I love picnic because it's, I would like to make it a very short service. And after that, there's food, fellowship, and there's a challenge. Then there is a challenge that we have the children, and some of them are already figuring out who is going to be the child. And we are going to watch that, and pretty soon we'll find out everything. And thank you, everyone. Can you hear me in the back? Thank you, everyone, for coming this morning. Come down. Yeah, we have some places. Yeah, here too.
And there's lots of space down here.
Yeah, a lot of places here. You can have the next slide.
Yeah, we're trying to figure that out.
Ethan's not here. I'm sorry.
Frank is kind of jumping in.
I was gonna say,
the next slide, the next one.
I'm already fired.
Okay, so one of the things that this morning, just I want to make an apology that we are not having the upper room book at this point because the renewal supposed to be done last month and we didn't figure out. And so what they did was, instead of sending July and August, they sent September and October. So the July and August is coming probably by this week, and hopefully it will be there for you next week. And we are sorry. And the second thing is that next Sunday we are having a Holy Communion service. And on Saturday, we are having a 200-year celebration, Allium Scrotum. And so Sean Taylor and his team is going to be here. It's going to be at 3 o'clock. So please come with your family and friends and invite. And it's a free concert. And there will be a free will offering there. And after that, we are going to have some fellowship time with all our friends and neighbors. So that way, we'll be having. So this morning, again, once again, I welcome everyone. Are there any announcements this morning? Any announcements?
I just want to make sure everybody knows the baby contest papers are down there. You might need the service and the meal to figure them out. I'm sorry. And I didn't want to exclude anybody, so there are 30. I'm sorry. I at least gave you the names.
There is a birthday card for Lois Kelso. Lois Kelso is going to celebrate her 100th birthday this Saturday. And, she will be in church next week, and there will be a luncheon the family is hosting. So please come and let us celebrate, and so 100 years. She must be the longest living person in our church. It looks like it appears. So come, let us celebrate. This morning, the worship service, there's no bulletin. Everything is going to be on the slide. And after the opening prayer, we are going to sing two songs from the booklet. It's going to be your choice. And after that, we are going to have scripture reading. And before scripture reading, we are going to have a small clip for the children. So I'm going to invite all the children to come here and watch the clip. And I will be talking to them. After that, we are going to have a scripture reading and a short sermon. And after that, the closing prayer. And this morning, the chicken crew, Bob Bonney and his team, they were having some trouble with the sporting guns. And so they'll be done. They'll be here pretty soon. So that way. So come, let us worship our God. Let us pray. gracious and merciful God, inviting us together this morning to worship you. We have come to worship you and say thank you, God, for giving us a beautiful day, giving us a time of fellowship, giving us the time to worship you, God. You are our creator. You be with us. Let your presence guide us and speak to us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, the choice, two selections. The first one, any of you a choice from the booklet?
Blessed Assurance.
Blessed Assurance. What page is it?
It's on page 6.
Page 6. Blessed Assurance. We have the choir director. Anybody would like to start the song? Good singers.
Through men. The Lord has promised good to me. His word my hope secures. He will my shield and portion be. As long as life endures.
Wonderful. Children, would you please come? Come down.
I think he has a
Yeah, you can sit here.
That's what I used to say too.
Come down this way.
Yeah, whenever they have it embedded in, it's pretty easy.
Girls, go around the front here. Around the front.
Go in the front. Yeah, come
go around.
Squeeze in the crack. Ah, you got it. Oh, yeah, you got it.
Yeah, but Jordan's
yeah, wow, look at that. Yeah. Yeah, come. We'll sit here. How is it? Come. Okay. Oh, yeah. Okay. How was everybody this morning?
Good.
How are you happy? Did you sleep well? Okay. Just I have a question. How many of you tell all the time the truth? All the time, truth. Nothing but the truth. Wow, look at that, only one. What happens to you? Okay, we'll watch a video. Okay, let's watch this video. This hour?
I don't know.
Just 1 second.
Where'd you afraid?
No, ma'am. But they tied me in a big shack.
Don't say. And where was their Jiminy?
Oh, Jiminy.
Leave me out of this.
They put him in a little shack.
No.
Yeah.
How did you escape?
I didn't. They chopped me into firewood. Oh, look. My nose. What's happened?
Perhaps you haven't been telling the truth, Pinocchio.
Perhaps.
Oh, but I have. Every single word. Oh, please help me. I'm awful sorry.
You see, Pinocchio, a lie keeps growing and growing until it's as plain as the nose on your face.
She's right, Pinocchio. You better come clean.
I'll never lie again. Honest, I won't.
Please, Your Honor. Miss Fairy, give him another chance. For my sake, will you?
Oh. I'll forgive you this once. But remember, a boy who won't be good might just as well be made of wood.
Okay, so what will happen if we tell the truth and our nose gets longer? Would it look good? Yeah? Oh, you have a long nose? Okay. So, the story tells us we have to tell the truth all the time. Speak the truth. Do you tell the truth all the time?
No.
Why?
I don't know.
You don't know? Do you want to lie all the time?
No, all the time.
No.
Same answer.
Same answer. Wow, you're very smart. What about you guys? Sometimes we lie. But what happens? When we lie, we have to say, I'm sorry. And then? That's what God wants us to be. God wants us to be all the time truthful. When we make a mistake and tell a lie, we have to ask God, I'm sorry. Isn't that? We have to say, I'm sorry. When we say, I'm sorry, God is there in Jesus Christ to forgive us. And He is going to say, okay, don't tell next time. That's what Christian life is. So when we talk next time, we have to be truthful. Isn't that nice? Yes. Okay, let us pray. Gracious God, help us to be truthful all the time. We are your children. Send us, O God, with your blessings to be the children of your truth. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay.
The scripture reading this morning is from Amos chapter 7, verse 7 to 15. This is what he showed me. The Lord was standing beside a wall built with a plumb line, with a plumb line in his hand. And the Lord said to me, Amos, what do you see? And I said, a plumb line. Then the Lord said, see, I am setting a plumb line in the midst of my people, Israel. I will never again pass them by. The high places of Isaac shall be made desolate, and the sanctuaries of Israel shall be laid to waste. And I will rise against the house of Jeroboam with the sword. Then Amaziah, the priest of Bethel, said to King Jeroboam of Israel, saying, Amos has conspired against you in the very center of the house of Israel. The land is not able to bear all his words. For thus Amos has said, Jeroboam shall die by the sword, and Israel must go into exile away from his land. And Amaziah said to Amos, O seer, flee away from the land of Judah. Earn your bread there and prophesy there, but never again prophesy at Bethel, for it is the king's sanctuary and it is the temple of the kingdom. Then Amos answered Amaziah, I am no prophet, nor a prophet's son, but I am a herdsman and a dresser of sycamore trees. And the Lord took me from following the flock, and the Lord said to me, go prophesy to my people Israel. That's the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Wow, this morning it is very interesting to see from Amos, and Amos is one of my favorite minor prophets. And some of his articles I translated from Hebrew to English and to my native language. And it is very interesting to observe very closely reading the old manuscripts of Hebrew. And how many of you or your family worked in a coal mine? Anybody's family worked in a coal mine? Yeah, the church that I served at the beginning in 1992, I started in Coldwood and Revlon near Evansburg. Those two towns are the coal mining towns. And that coal mining started in 1910. So two Presbyterians, one is Coleman and the other one is Weaver. So they put together the first three letters of Coleman and the last three letters of Weaver. They started the town called Coldwood. Wow, the Presbyterians have more influence there. So they are the coal mining bosses. So the coal from Coldwood, and then later on in 1917, they started another town called Revlon. The same bosses. So they spelled it backwards. It became Revlon. if you travel on 422 towards Ebensburg, 422 east, you won't miss the town Revlon. And so, this coal mining town, they always tell the stories how dangerous the coal mining towns are, our coal miners are. When they used to go, they didn't know what's going to happen on that day. Because the carbon monoxide, it'll kill instantly. So in those days, they used to carry chirping canaries, the yellow board. So the yellow board is the indicator of them to tell the carbon monoxide, the board will die first, then. So this morning, it's an indicator that being a prophet, God called Amos to be a prophet. And we know the prophets are the people who tell what's going to happen in the future. But here in Amos' story and all the prophets in the Old Testament, these prophets tell what God has asked him to speak. They were the mouthpieces of God, and they begin, "Thus says the Lord." They begin the word by saying, "Thus says the Lord." So this morning, "Thus says the Lord," and Amos is telling, and he was carrying a plumb line. Many of us are carpenters, we like to have a plumb line to make sure that it's straight. Without a plumb line, we cannot. Now we have the,
laser printer. Laser pointer.
Yeah, lasers one, and we look at that. But in those days, the plumb line, and saying, God is showing, show and tell this morning. Show, tell them, the plumb line is off the line. What's going to happen? Either you fall or straighten up. And also, when we are called to speak the truth, it's very, very hard. Sometimes, somebody carry the message and they'll tell me, or I will go and I'm only the messenger. Don't shoot me. But still, you are shot and you are the first one to die. The same thing can happen in Amos. Amos life, only the messenger, but he carries the truth to tell the people, this is what God is saying. Your plumb line is off, way off, correct now. And God gives time to rectify. God gives ample time. It's going to happen sometime soon. In the meanwhile, behave yourself. So when I was looking at the scripture, when Amos, what are the things? What did they do? The first thing is that the rich people, 4,000 years back, the rich people were getting richer. Is it different? No. And the poor are becoming poor. We are not treating the poor right. That's what God said. They are among you. You are not sharing. You are not treating them right. There are a lot of opportunities God is giving us to treat one another with respect and love. But we are ending up with something, being sarcastic. We are using the word put downs. And we are saying that, oh, by the way, this is not the church for you. No, this church is for everyone. This is God's church. We are all the sojourners. In the sojourners, we are children of God, accepting and accommodating. When I was serving in a committee in the General Assembly of the Presbyterian Church USA, we had a skit. How would you rearrange your table? And how many of you have the extension for your dining table? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Whenever the guests come, pull it, add it, put more chairs. How do we accommodate people in our church? We are a little bit rigid. Oh, this is, by the way, this has been my seat for centuries. This is how we have been doing it. This is the way it will work here. Because you are the newbie. We are trying to keep the lineage the same way as it was in the beginning, will be and forever.
No.
God is saying, change it. Make a U-turn. Repent. And accept. That's what we watched in the children's talk too. When we accept, there is forgiveness. The forgiveness of God. We want to be a church accepting, accommodating, welcoming. And this is where God wants us, the nation, to be. And look at Amos. Amos is telling, I'm neither a prophet nor a prophet's son, but God called me. Why is he saying that? Many times, there is no definition to be God's children. There is no, everybody is God's children. Everybody, God wants everybody to be the prophets. You can be a prophet. You can be a preacher. You can be the pastor. You can be the peacemaker. When God anoints you, when God calls me, that's what Amos saying, that I was a dresser of a sycamore tree. And that's one profession. And the second profession is, I'm a shepherd boy. But God called me. God called me to speak the truth. That's my message, to speak the truth for God. And I'm here this morning. Whether you accept it or not, just I'm the messenger. If you want to shoot me, go ahead. This is what is the message of all of us. Because God knows you, who you are. You can say that, God, I've been the shepherd boy, very good. I can do the cutting the trees and dressing the sycamore tree. But when God said, Amos, go tell the truth. Open their eyes. Open their eyes. But in the meanwhile, Amaziah is the royal chaplain. And he says, go away, don't come here. Don't speak that kind of language. Because people doesn't want to listen the truth. They don't want to. They don't want to hear what God is saying to us. And God is saying, take care of my children. When Jesus called Peter at the last, after the resurrection, Jesus was roasting the fish on the seashore. And when Peter recognized that it was Jesus who was roasting the fish, and the conversation goes like this, Jesus looked at Peter, do you love me? Do you love me? Three times. After the third time, he tells Peter, Will you feed my sheep? Will you feed my sheep? The call is huge for us. This morning we have come to worship here in this beautiful place. How are we going to accommodate? We can speak all the violent rhetoric. We can speak everything, putting down and not accepting. You are not my class. You are not my caste. But God is calling. Treat your brother. Treat your sister the way you are being treated. You are expecting that somebody should treat you better the same way you should treat others. Today the message of hope is for my church and for our church, for the church of God, is we have to be a welcoming, we have to be accepting, accommodating the children of God. This is the church God has called. If not, God will send Amos like people to tell the truth. To tell the truth. How are you treating my children? How are you treating my neighbor? Today is the challenge. As a church, come, let us walk with the presence of the Holy Spirit to accept, to accommodate. Walk an extra mile to share the love of Jesus Christ that God has given to us. Amen. At this time, we are going to receive the offertory. Let us pray. Holy and gracious God, the gifts that you have given to us, to use it, to share, and to proclaim your love. Gracious God, this morning, like Amos has said, I'm neither a prophet nor a prophet's son, but God called me. I was going after the sheep. I was dresser of the sycamore tree, but God called me to proclaim the truth. Today you are calling us, O God. Give us the wisdom and knowledge to use this gift for your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The closing song, and Bob Moni called a few minutes back, and how many minutes you want? I said 20 minutes. 20 minutes will end in 5 minutes. So. Okay. Any of your choice? Yes.
You got the whole world in his hands.
What is that, Mike?
You got the whole world in his hands.
Oh, okay. I got the whole world. What page is that?
11.
Page number 11. Peace like a river. Oh, he got the whole world in his hands. Oh, I'm sorry. Okay.
Mother was right there, and of course, I don't sing very well. Horribly, actually. So, our son came and he studied opera, so he's right behind her and they sing him and she turns around. Oh my, Andrew, you have a beautiful voice. And I said, what about me? She said, Andrew, I've never heard such a beautiful voice. That's how to defer so you don't have to lie.
That's a good story. Any joys, prayer requests? Any birthdays?
Next Saturday.
Yeah. Oh, happy birthday. God bless you. Kathy, happy birthday.
Rick's is on Thursday.
Oh, Rick. Happy birthday, Rick.
Nicole's was last week.
Wow.
Happy
belated birthday.
Yeah, we are so happy to see Jim.
Yes.
Welcome back, Jim. Thank you. Jim had a surgery. Nice to see you.
No, but my wife is coming home today. She's been in Brookville Hospital since Tuesday. And they finally, we believe, have her pain under control as best they can. So she's walking much better, and she's pretty excited. So.
Don Musgrave's. When is Don?
He's chicken.
Thursday is Don Musgrave's birthday. Happy birthday, Don. I think he might be coming. Chicken is coming soon, okay? Pauline's birthday is tomorrow. Happy birthday, Pauline. Okay. Let us pray. Holy and merciful God, we give you thanks. Bringing us together this morning, we give you thanks, O God, for every blessing. This morning you called us to speak the truth. Sometimes we don't know. You call us very surprisingly. We may say that we are not qualified, but still, O God, you keep us. When you call, you keep us, and you call us by name to proclaim the truth. Whatever is the resistance, you are energizing with the Holy Spirit. Today, O God, energize us with your power of grace, power of love. Send us, O God, with your love to proclaim that truth with our family, with our children, with our neighbors, with our country. To make a difference, O God. We give you thanks for your children who brought all these things. The gift of love. We give you thanks. Thank you, God, for bringing us to celebrate this annual picnic. We give you thanks. And we remember your children who are celebrating the birthdays, the recoverings. Gracious God, we lift up your children who need the healing mercy of God. Sometimes we say it in love, but sometimes deep down in our hearts we pray. We ask your healing mercy, O God. We also pray for our country. Violence is not the answer. Help us, O God, to speak peace, love, and kindness. Help us, O God, to be a loving people in our country. We pray this prayer in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray, saying,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive
us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever.
Go into the world to speak the truth. God is calling you. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you so much. Thank you for joining.